Controller.
We're in. Boom. We're in. See that controller? We're controlling the magic of TV, radio. But these gents are controlling the magic of music. It's Dirty Heads joining us at the Vans Warped Tour 2013. All right. How's it going?
I like that intro.
Not bad, was it? Off the cuff.
Like an intro.
Improvised, dude. Just threw it out there.
Perfect.
Could we riff improvised music, do you reckon?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Just do it. Okay. Yeah.
Sea shanty?
A sea shanty, yeah. Because we've got the beards and the long hair.
Okay.
Once upon a time, I was talking dirty hats. They joined me here, and this is what they said.
Hee me hearty, we are pirates on the tour. The Warp Tour is where we play for the whores.
Boom! Back of the net, just off the cuff, see? Just threw it out. Amazing. Gents, you're from California. Yes. How is it to be in miserable England?
You know, it's like 85 degrees in California right now. Yeah, so it fucking sucks. No. We're stoked. We actually came from Florida.
Did you see the complete look of like a disacknowledgement there? Because I don't know what 85 degrees means. 85 degrees. We work in Celsius here, dude. Yeah. I was like, that's as hot as the sun.
770. Yes, I don't know what it is Celsius.
Is everybody
but
there dead?
It was
then?
Sunny. It was sunny. Yeah.
It would suck, 85 degrees Celsius. Everyone's dying. Everyone's just dying. Burning.
It's tragedy. Pray for California.
So it's not that nice over there, is what you're saying?
It's really nice over there.
It is really nice. Yeah.
But
sucks to be here.
It's great to be here. I mean, it's our first time doing a European tour. It's our second time in the UK. We came over here, but we did like a couple acoustic shows.
Okay.
So to play with the full band at a Warped Tour is pretty cool. We're stoked.
I mean, the Warped Tour is a little bit of an establishment, isn't it? Like, it's kind of a cool thing to be able to do, and sort of a nod and a mark of respect to the bands that play it. So do you feel like, oh, we're up there with some of our heroes who played in the past now?
Yeah, I mean, definitely. I grew up, you know, going to Warped Tours before I was in a band, so now to be a part of them, it's pretty cool.
You have got long blonde hair. You are from California. You are in a band. You are the stereotypical Vans Tour kind of guy, aren't you? Do you skateboard?
I used to
skateboard. Of course you fucking did, yeah.
Now I'm old.
Have you ever smoked marijuana?
Every fucking day.
Amazing. How many excellent adventures have you guys been on?
A lot.
One too many. Zurich, yes. Kicked the shit out of me.
Tell me about Zurich.
We started drinking really early. It was our first day off in like a week or so. Let's just say it ended with security having to take me back to my room and put me to bed twice.
Nice. Did they tuck you in when they did that or just kick you through the door?
I think I had to fight my way to bed. Because everybody else was so blacked out that it was just it was a good night.
Bodies were debris that you had to move out of the way to get to your bed.
Yes.
Yeah.
And do you have a particular favorite city when you're doing Europe? Because Zurich obviously has some kind of, well, I was going to say fond memories, but it sounds like you can't remember a fucking thing that happened there.
You know what? I had a blast in Utrecht. Utrecht? Is that how you say it?
Yeah. Utrecht.
Utrecht. I had a blast there. We didn't know. We had a day off, and we were just walking around. I randomly ran into this coffee shop that sold marijuana, and I was like, you gotta be kidding me. So I hung out there all day long.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what happened?
That I sat there and smoked pot.
So you really broke out of the normal schedule you hold in California.
Yes. But no, it was awesome. But that town's actually beautiful. We walked around and we just had a good time there.
See, you're giving it the rock and roll, the big rock and roll I am, but I feel like you're cultured individuals. You're intelligent men, I can tell that. Do you take in some of the local culture and the sights when you come over to somewhere like London?
We do. We definitely make a point to get
stop off the National Portrait Gallery. Smoke some weed.
We did that.
Reaper Bond. We went to the Reaper Bond. Lit a little window shopping. Didn't go in. Didn't get anything, but we did.
You just had a look at the pretty lights. And
yeah, exactly.
And the pretty outfits. Vans Warped Tour, obviously, I mean, again, it's just an establishment, but is there a part of it that you hated so far?
Oh, fuck yeah.
There's a lot of parts.
What parts have you hated?
Well, for a band, this is an amazing tour.
Band names, we'd really appreciate that.
No. But no, for a band, this is obviously an amazing tour because you get to get out in front of a lot of people that wouldn't come to see your band.
Free shoes as well.
But Jesus Christ, it's a grueling tour, and it's a tough one. You know, when you're done with the Warped Tour,
what's the grueling aspect of it?
Well, when we did the first one in the States, I'd say 5 years ago, we were still in a van, a 15-passenger van with like 8 dudes, and we didn't have enough money for hotels. We had to drive ourselves. We had to wake up at 7 in the morning, set up
our own. Like real rock and roll.
Yeah, that's like when I really started heavily drinking at 7 in the morning, because you would have to get up, do your own fucking merch, sell your own merch all day. You'd play at 10 in the morning or 11 in the morning sometimes you play at 8 at night, and you know, you had to drive yourselves, so there was no sleep. you know, but it was a blast. And, you know, a lot of other bands that are bigger can really, you paid your dues. You know how it is. You didn't just fucking hop on a tour bus, share it with somebody else, and, you know, have showers every day.
Whereas nowadays, these kids coming along, they're just jumping on your tour bus.
No, ours is bullshit. Nobody's on our tour bus.
No one's allowed on your tour bus anymore.
Fucking not.
We were gonna jump along. We were thinking you could enjoy some sea shanties as you go.
Dude, you guys are okay with us.
Yeah, you hear that? Enter Shikari, go fuck yourselves. We're getting on the tour bus with the Dirty Heads. We're gonna play some sea shanties. We might smoke some weed. We might take in some local sights, enjoy some culture. We might do something out of the box and play Scrabble at 4 p.m. You can't fucking tell us what to do because we're real rock and roll.
Yep.
What's the crowds like in the UK compared to back home? Because we are a bit more rowdy, I would think.
Yeah, you know what? You guys like to dance over here. Like, everyone's dancing, and it's good. It's not like that in the States. You know, it's like, if it's not your band that you're going to see and you know every song, you're probably just standing there watching. Here, people, they don't know us. They're still dancing.
Well,
they're still
having a good time.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. So no, I like it. I like it here. The crowds are good.
Do you have any like kind of banter you have with the audience when you're on stage? Is there a particular kind of back and forth that you always try and encourage?
Well, I just try and wing it. I don't try and plan. And if you plan it too much, it's a little stale.
Have you ever had a good heckle from an audience member?
Oh fuck yeah, all the time. But the thing is I have a microphone. I can be like, oh, that's fucking Mike with herpes. Stop yelling, Mike with herpes. You know, yeah. But I have a microphone. You have nothing.
This is it. We both do stand up comedy, and we find that amplification always helps in making your point, doesn't it?
Oh. Well, yeah, yelling like this, and no one can hear what you're saying. It doesn't matter because you go on the mic and say, oh, fuck off, and everyone goes, yeah, fuck off.
What's the most sort of rock and roll aspect of this particular tour? Because I feel like, I'm going to be honest with you guys, you look like the first people on this tour that are actually like a rock and roll band.
Everyone says that to every single
No, band. No, I don't. I actually don't say that. I know. That's my life, man. I can't help it. I wake up in the morning like this. But every other band have been like really sort of sweet, and they're really like, hi, yeah, we're just really grateful to be playing the Vans World Tour. It's like, oh, fuck off. Go home and eat your mum's tit or whatever you were doing last week. Like, everyone's really soft on Vans. Whereas you guys seem a bit more like, you got a bit more grunt about you. Well, is that just because you've
been touring for a long time? We've been touring for 10, 11 years, so we're over being nice.
So you're bitter and cynical.
We do heroin and then suck on our fucking fellow band members' mom's tits is what we do. That's
something else. I was like, are you gonna say dick right now?
No, they can go home.
You're gonna say he sucks on our
You're gonna tell everyone about that? Because
that was a secret.
Yeah.